Phil Currier was a model of courageous kindness and a big reason why we care about it at Columbus Academy. Tonight, we are honored to have many members of Phil's family with us. Two of his three children, Megan is not with us. We have Ann and her oldest son, Jack, who is the oldest grandson of Phil. And we have Phil's son, David, and his wife, Wendy, as well. And their daughter, May, is hopefully heading to bed here soon, right?
Chance to speak at the National Civil Rights Museum, which is at the Lorraine Motel, which is where Dr. King was assassinated almost 50 years ago now. And when I was there, I was reminded of Dr. King's notion of beloved community, right? This idea that we could mature into a world that sees beyond prejudice and discrimination, that our circles of compassion could grow beyond our own immediate families to encompass all people. And I think you don't have to look very far to recognize that we've fallen short of that ideal. I've had the really good luck to work as a travel photographer both across the United States and around the world. And I've come to realize that it's my job to find beauty in unexpected places. Right? People hire me to find good where others might struggle to see it. But that doesn't mean that we ignore the challenges of the world. Right, because there are plenty of challenges, and I think it's important that we face them head on and honestly, but I also think it's really important that we face those challenges with a grace and a faith and a belief that something better is possible. I was increasingly frustrated with the quality of our national dialogue. I was concerned about all the things that ask us to look at what separates us, whether it's politics, ethnicity, religion, gender, class, you name it. If you choose to go through life dividing, you've got all sorts of tools at your disposal. I wondered what would happen if I used my photography and storytelling instead to look at what connects us, to rediscover that common humanity that we all share. I started playing with this question, what does peace mean to you? And on the surface, that's a really simple question, but it very quickly gets at the core of who we are as human beings and what we value as a society. Right, it opens the door to all sorts of conversations about race and gender issues, about civic responsibility, international policy, and national priorities. And I realized very quickly that A Piece of My Mind was a project about listening, which is something we don't always do well. Right, we listen in order to respond or to refute or rebut, but we don't always listen simply to understand. At first, we just shared these as podcasts. And when I started listening, I started hearing little bits of wisdom that I think get lost in the noise of day-to-day life. So I talked to people like Imani Jafar Muhammad, who's a lawyer and a partner in a law firm. In her free time, she goes around to schools and community groups, and she talks about what it means to be a Muslim woman in America today. And Imani says that every once in a while, she'll give these two-hour presentations, and she'll have some guy stand up in the back and say, well, I think you're so oppressed. She responds, you don't even know me. Right? It's as if everything she said is untrue just because that person chose not to believe it. Right? We struggle with a shrunken notion of our own abilities. We have the ability to bring change, but often we don't own that. We're afraid of that. In fact, we can bring change, and it often comes from a small group of dedicated and persistent people. And so my question for you tonight is, can we be those people? We can do big things. It took me about 3 years to put together the exhibit that was here at Columbus Academy. It took me another year to put together the book. I was really looking for a more nimble way to respond to some of the social issues of the day, a way to drop into a community for a shorter period of time and really create an interesting body of work. And Columbus Academy is one of the first places we did that. And we spent a day with the students and we asked them this question, what does courageous kindness mean to you? Thank you. Sometimes we get stuck on the problems, right? Sometimes we sit and dwell only on the problems without acknowledging the solutions. And for me, when I see stories like this, I see 38 solutions, 38 models for how we can move forward to create that better world. So thank you to all of you for raising good students and for them sharing their stories. You know, these stories are everywhere. These stories that I've gathered for a piece of my mind. They're in this room here tonight, I'm sure of it. They're certainly at Columbus Academy, because I've heard some of them. And they're in the bigger world. I think that it's our job to hear them. It's our job to take the time to listen to these stories, to use what we hear to recognize the humanity in others, especially maybe in this day, those that we consider our adversaries, to reach out across that divide. And if we can do that, I think our odds are better of creating that beloved community that Dr. King talked about, and I think our odds are better at creating a little more peace. Thank you.